Hi everyone. So another thing that you might need when you're writing your reports in PowerPoint instead of Word is the ability to comment on things like you would in Word via track changes or something like that in that review panel. Now, PowerPoint has very similar commenting features as Word, but it isn't quite as extensive. So if you're doing a report in PowerPoint and you are sharing it across platform or with other coworkers or colleagues that you need to have feedback on or other types of edits, you can absolutely create those here in PowerPoint. Just know that it's not quite as extensive that you would have in something like Microsoft Word. But I want to go ahead and show you how you might comment on something so that your coworker can see it and then review it later on. So here in your PowerPoint slide, let's just say that here's this text box here and I don't really understand what this means. So I want to make sure that my coworker has this comment when I send them the document for review. So what I'm going to do is go up here to the ribbon and go to the review tab. And you can see that you have a bunch of different options here, but I'm going to go into this comment section here. And I want to go and do a new comment, but I want to make sure that the comment is about this text box. So first, I'm going to highlight the text box and I'm going to go up here to that review tab and then click on new comment. And you can see that it's going to give your name and it's going to say, here's a little text box that you can use to start your comment. So I'm going to say, hey coworker, I don't understand the first paragraph of this text box. And then you're going to go ahead and submit it with the icon and the comment is right there. And you can see that it actually uses when you click over here in the comments pane, it'll tell you where this specific comment is. And in this case, I have the entire text box highlighted because that's where I want to draw their attention to. Now I could go ahead and close out of the comments pane and you don't see any of the comments here. But if you go up to the review tab again, click on this show comments drop down bar, you can see that the comments pane isn't revealed. And now I just revealed it by clicking on that. The same thing if you click on, if you click on advanced markup, then what you're going to do is see this little comment box here in the document where that comment is located. So then I could, let's close out of the comment box and see what happens. So I have my advanced markup selected and you can see that somebody left a comment here. I'm going to go ahead and click on it. It says click to show comments pane and it'll open the comment and tell me exactly where that comment is and what that comment says. Now, if I'm a commenter and I want to edit the comment, I just click on the ellipses up here and I can edit my comment if I want to. I can also delete my comment this way. And if there was a bunch of people who replied to this thread, I could also resolve it and just say no more there. So that's pretty nice. And then you can just sort of delete that thread and then it doesn't show up anymore on that advanced markup pane. So that's one way that you can use kind of a different version of track changes in PowerPoint, sort of similar how you would do it in Microsoft Word. Stay tuned for my final video, which is just going to show you how to complete your report building process in PowerPoint by saving your PowerPoint as a PDF so that you can email it to the world. Have a great day. Thank you.